Yo, what's up? Name's JetLeo1, and welcome to, and I never thought I'd be saying this, Let's Play number 29, Dead or Alive Extreme 2. Oh, boy. Like, we're going off the wall whenever I skip my usual joke of, like, saying Let's Play playthrough in, like, a bunch of weird ways. Because, oh man, like, this started as a Twitter joke, where I was like, I'm gonna buy this game and let's play it next. And then Resident Evil 5 stopped being recordable on my PC, so I actually did it. Well, here we are. So let's just jump right into the fun, because fun this is, because, like, I actually bought this game about a week ago. But, I did do a practice run, and I had fun. And this is gonna be fun, because all the other Let's Plays I've done, and all the other Let's Plays, like, that I mainly will be doing, have been, like, really just story-based games where I'm like, I want to share this game with you. And, like, we follow the story, and I skip all the side quests and just go through the story, and we do the thing very strict. But this is a freeform game, you can't do that. So, like, it's just, it's gonna be, you're gonna do what we do. And I do have some goals. I'll lay the goals down. Unlike most things I've seen of this, like, I saw Proton John play this, I saw Maximilian play this, he played the whole series, actually, and, like, the best friends played this, but they all just did two-week runs and, like, cut it down. I'm going to play through as all nine girls. The full 2 weeks is all nine girls, and each of those 2 weeks, I've got basically three goals, and that's, one, I want to create what I would consider the perfect outfit for each character, customized individually for each character. I'm not just gonna, like, buy the same things. I'm not gonna be Max and be like, I'm gonna buy the $1 million like piece of string swimsuit. Like, no, that's not happening. I'm gonna have style. I'm gonna accessorize, and like everybody else who's gonna play this, it's gonna be the perfect outfit.
Look, Zach, it's working.
Hopefully. Sometimes things don't spawn. Second goal, I want to win every event with each character, which, if you know about the water slide, is harder than it sounds. And three is basically like a half and half goal. I want to make over $1 million Zack Bucks on every character, and buy the watercraft for the water races that I like, which costs slightly over $1 million. So the goals go together. So that's it. Gotta dress fancy, win games, and make money. And this is pretty much what little plot you get. Because at the end of the first Extreme Volleyball, Zack's Island sunk, so he brought it back up. And now the girls are coming back for more vacations. Which is a lie. They all have their own individual reasons for coming to the island. Which I have this handy-dandy instruction manual here to say why. And I'm not going to be doing anything too special. I'm just going to go through the characters left to right. But I do want to make a note that I find it interesting how they selected the characters of this game, because this game is based on Dead or Alive 4, but there are way more female characters in that game. There's only 9 here. How did they choose them? They chose them with a popularity poll, because, okay. So we ended up with these girls. We've got at least, we have the main character, which is required, but then, like, I guess we got the main cast, really. Which is the important part, but it's a little weird that it's not everybody, but oh well. You can't win them all. You can't have the perfect island paradise every time. But anyways, we're going to go left to right for our character selection. We're going to start with Kasumi. So from the booklet, Kasumi is a runaway ninja who abandoned her position as head of the Mugen Tenshin clan to avenge her brother Hayate. She came to New Zack Island upon hearing that her brother was there, even though she wondered what he was doing on a tropical island. So let's get started. And another fun fact that I have the manual up here. Each character actually has stats in 5 categories. Beaches. Which affects how they perform in mini games. That is way too much thought put into this game.
Morning, Kasumi.
Oh, Lisa.
But, and here's the sad part.
So, you're here on vacation
so when you
too?
Start, Lisa is going to give you the tutorial. And Lisa is your starting partner here. Because this is a partner based game. Because you can't play beach volleyball
We're
alone.
Talking about Zack. He'd never invite
but
me
luckily,
here.
You can switch to whatever character you want as long as you can get them to like you.
You mean.
Hey, don't let
and,
it
hey, look,
down.
Plot. Hayate's not here. What a surprise. Again, did you really think that Zack was gonna just let Hayate on here when I'm pretty sure, like, I don't know the plot of Dead or Alive 4, but I'm pretty sure Hayate probably just beat up Zack somewhere in the tournament? It's just because it's what Hayate does.
There are 3 shops here on your
anyways, Kasumi's stats are 1 in power, 5 in technique, 3 in defense, 5 in jump, and 3 in speed. So she's gonna be pretty good at the hard, like, the really fancy techniques in volleyball, and probably pretty good at wave race. Because she'll have the technique to maneuver the watercraft easily. but her spikes are going to leave something to be desired. So here's her tutorial. Currently, Lisa's running through the three shops. I can explain the three shops better than she can. There's the accessory shop where you can get exactly what it says. You get accessories, and you can also get cosmetics, which we're buying pink nail polish. Come on. Don't need to get for that because it's for us. And then I don't know if I want to bother because there's a tanning system in the game. And if you get suntan lotion, you'll tan faster. And if you get sunscreen, you won't tan. And like whenever you switch swimsuits, you'll have tan lines. Like you'll actually have a tan based on what swimsuit you were wearing before. But hopefully I can pick a good, like a really good outfit fast and not switch too much. But what do we have here? Okay. Like, I'm trying to figure in my head already what outfit I want for Kasumi. We got pink. Her starter outfit is pink. Like, purple's kind of close. We're going to get this. Don't need to get that because it's for us. Orange ribbon. Purple. Like, that's more for Ayane, but whatever. It'll do for now until we can get something properly pink. I would buy the white flower, but flowers actually die, which got me so good when I did my practice run as Tina, because I was like, oh, this flower looks super good on Tina. And then, like, the next day, Tina woke up and was like, your flower died. And I was like, oh, no. Okay, so this is the sports shop. This is where you buy the more event-related objects. You buy new swimsuits, you buy watercrafts, and you can buy the other mini-game tickets, because you only start with three mini-games. You start with beach volleyball, wave race, and pool hopping. And you have to unlock tug-of-war, butt battle, water slide, and beach flags. And luckily they're not too expensive. Hopefully I can find a nice cheap outfit. It's kind of cute. The problem is that most of the outfits are really expensive, and they also take forever to load. Like, you can't install this game. It loads so slow. Okay. Ooh. That's pretty nice, actually. I quite like that. This is more her color scheme. But I can't afford that. I can afford this, though. It's a little boring. But that's too flowery. Like, I take my fashion very seriously, guys, okay? I don't know. Let's start with this. Just cuz. Like, it's cute. I like cute. I don't really want to deck out my characters in, like, full sexy gear. I want to go with, like, the cute. They're on a vacation. Just, they want to have fun. So, where's my baby? That's not my baby. There you are. My beautiful stingray. Look at that cornering! Actually, no, it's not the stingray. It's you. Look at that. Just balanced stats. Beautiful. The only thing better is the tiger shark, because that is a great dirty cheating machine. Look at those stats. It's got three boosts. It's got just as much cornering as the corner specialization machine. And it's got max acceleration. It's crazy. And then here is where you can buy your minigame tickets. I'm going to buy the cheap ones. The most important one to buy when you start is beach flags, because beach flags is easy money. If you don't feel confident enough in doing wave race or beach volleyball, because just mashing A button, just don't race against Helena or Kokoro because their speed are really high. And then we could get tug of war ticket. Let's just unlock the game. And as part of my goals for the Let's Play, I wanted to do every event as every character, so we're gonna have to buy all of these as every character. Luckily, money is not really an issue unless you're trying to, like, 100%, in which case, good luck, kiddo, you're gonna get wrecked. Because, oh boy, there is so much stuff, and it's for every character. Like, I don't know if money is separated among the characters, but I know the items are.
This is Zack of all trades. They sell all sorts of
and
stuff.
And the last store is the gift shop. This is where you can buy gifts to give to your partners to make them like you. You can sleep in at the end of the day instead of just going to bed normally, and that will make your partner leave you if you want to get rid of them, and then you can pick up someone else from any of the places on the island. Or you can give gifts to your current partner, and that will make them happier, and that will make them play better in beach volleyball, and they will be more likely to not abuse the rubber band AI in wave race and let you win. So, prototype Xbox. Kasumi coin. I'm sure Ayane would like that. But we're stuck with Lisa. Lisa's very tech-savvy, so the notebook computer would be a good call, but don't got the money because I bought the mini games. And then there's gift wrapping, because you want to gift wrap gift wrap all of your gifts, because you can't give them to somebody without gift wrapping it, but you want to wrap it in that person's favorite color, which, thankfully, the copy I got has the instruction manual, like I read from the beginning. So I know what color
to
give to everybody.
Watercraft to participate. Those are sold at the store.
So here's Wave Race, and they give you
try racing me?
A free Wave Race machine when you go here if you don't buy one. It's the Dolphin. But look at those garbage stats. And, like, it's even worse because they have the audacity to sell those in the shop with, like, one more point on the stats and then just different paint jobs. Like, no, I want a better vehicle if I'm going to pay for it. Controls are simple. A to go, L to turn. The triggers do drifts, and X does tricks on courses with ramps. This course is the basic course. We just go in a circle. We don't have a ramp. And the controls are actually, well, I don't quite know how to judge them, because the handling is, like, super, like, affects majorly how each vehicle handles. Because, like, when I switched to my Stingray, when I got it on the practice file, like, oh boy, I turned, and it was glorious. But the way this works is we have, down the bottom right, we have our speedometer, and then the little container is our charges of turbo. Different vehicles have different levels of turbo that they can hold. At the bottom left is a gauge that fills when you stay on the proper side of the buoys, just like Wave Race, which is why I'm going to keep calling this Wave Race. And every time you fill up the bar, you get a boost. And using your boost smart is going to be the way you win, because, like, I mentioned Rubber Band AI, and I'm not kidding. Like, it makes Mario Kart look tame. Because they will just be utterly crushing you, and then you can boost right past them and win, and then, like, you can just boost right past them because they won't go too far for you to not be able to catch up. So you can just hit a boost, it'll put you right past them, and then they will lose, but then the clock will be like, oh, they lost by 3 seconds. Like, no, they were right behind me. I saw them.
You can play all sorts of
games. It's just like, the better you do, the better they do. The worse you do, the worse they do. And it is so strong rubber banding, it's crazy. And before we go into pool hopping, I'm going to remember what button it is to go into the inventory. And I'm going to put on from my city, put on from my town. Let's see, put on the nail polish, equip the ocean volleyball, and play. This makes me so happy because you can change your hairstyle. I'm wearing the ponytail. Like, I love ponytails. Tina, why wouldn't you let me change your hairstyle? That makes me sad. But anyways, pool hopping time. In our new outfit. So it's just tap or hold the button to jump. And I hate this game. I hate all three of the pool mini games because they're so jank. Like, the controls just mess up and they're so hard, which is why it's a challenge that I'm going for to win everything. It's like, watch. See, that's what I'm talking about. I tapped Y and it did long jump. And I know it's not my controller, because I played Final Fantasy XIV 4 hours today, and it didn't mess up once. But no, I tap Y, and she goes for a long jump right into the water. Oh, boy. Oh, there's going to be fun times. Next? I'm going to get so mad at this game, because I love this game. It's fun, but it doesn't like me back. It's just no respect. It's disrespect. And our opening match is against Tina, and I believe that's Kokoro. So let me check the guide real quick. So, Tina, I know, her stats are garbage, except her power is through the roof, so she will spike that ball 3 feet into the dirt and mess you up. And let's see, the one with the... My problem is I confuse Lei Fang and Kokoro, and I feel really bad. Let's see, Kokoro's the one with the hair ornament. She's got pretty good power. Her thing is speed. She's got decent defense. So, thing is, Kasumi, like I said, good jump, good technique. And then Lisa is the jack of all stats. She's got a 3 in everything, if I remember. But the thing is that, like, all the time, like, practicing this, she's let me down so many times. It's amazing. And, like, this playing volleyball is gonna be the thing where, like, the most exciting commentary in this Let's Play comes from, because, oh boy, it elicits feelings. Ooh, okay. Just no mercy. Spike it in there. Thank you. Just, ooh boy, the feelings. Because you saw that. That was the saddest freaking serve. Oh, good. Please follow up. Thank God. What was that? This game is so weird. Like, look at that. They just stood there and looked at it. And, like, I blocked it. And Lisa was like, okay. It's like, no, that was a spike setup. Don't do that. Like, I haven't... Oh, my God. That is just insane. Do it again, Lisa. They're not even looking. Okay. They spike on themselves. Do I even need to play right now? Can I just put the controller down? That block. Oh, my God. I was about to be so mad if Lisa just stood there and looked at it. All right, please set it. Set it. Spiked it. Thank you. Whew, okay. Like, I haven't even... I wanted to explain how, like, there's the two kinds of serves. Wow, okay, we both missed that. Like, there's two kinds of serves you can do, because you can do, like, that where you just knock the ball over. And it's all casual, and it's like, yay. And they just sit there and stare as they spike the ball down in the center. But there's two kinds of serve. You can just casually toss it, or you can do forward and spike it, which I should stop doing as Kasumi, because she can't hit the ball. Like, okay, I get it. Her power is 1 heart out of 5. But do you really need to torture me like that? And is it really torture when they just keep spiking on themselves? See, this is why I said we were going to have fun, because this is going to happen a lot. Just stuff like this, like the pool hopping. Pool hopping. And wave raise is the one that makes the most sense, and even then I'm going to lose it. Because, like, you watch, I'm going to be in first place, just completely dominating. And then I'm going to try to drift too hard and fall off the thing. They're just going to pass me, and I'm going to be sad. And then I'm going to boost past them and win, and the thing is going to be like, you beat them by 3 seconds, and I'm going to get even madder because that's a lie. And this game is so much fun. Okay, back to proper mechanics, introducing the game. Because that's what you do in the first episode. At the end of your first day as each girl, you get to pick where they stay. There are 3 places to choose from. There's the middle-class Moonlight Reef with a nice ocean water theme. There is the Gemstone Suite, which is your high-end, like, super fancy hotel. And the one we're going for with Kasumi is the Starbreeze Cottage, or the Seabreeze Cottage. Starbreeze would be way cooler and also would be making payday too. But the Seabreeze Cottage is a cottage on the water. And it's very simple. I'm like, kind of rustic, feels kind of outdoorsy, and since it's on the water, it's very close to nature, and considering Kasumi's a ninja girl, that's what you would like.
What a day!
What a day indeed. You barely did anything because your volleyball opponents dunked on themselves. And then at the end of every night, Zack gives you a gift. Sometimes they're things you like, most of the time you're gonna re-gift it to your partner. That's pretty good. Although I think on the first night with every girl, he gives you a camera, because cameras are how you take your screenshots when you're chillaxing by the pool or go swimming or whatever. But we're not going to worry about that. What we are going to worry about right now to end off this video is where all the money is going to go and why the fact it's actually going to be a challenge to get a million. Because, oh boy, the casino. Like, there are 2 things that this game is known for. And they are Itagaki's ridiculous sexualization of the girls in this game. And the casino. So we're gonna, every vacation, we're gonna make the candy bet. And we're gonna put loads of money on 21. Every character. And that's gonna be pretty much the only roulette, because... Like, I managed to win big in my practice one. I got like, what did I get? I got like 5 million? No. I got like 8 million because I bet on 27. I bet on my birthday. And I got 8 million. I was like, sweet. But that's never going to happen again because Lady Luck doesn't like me. But we're going to bet on 21 every time. So I got my red bet. So what, 28,000 after I put in 200? Whatever. I'm backing down, and we're gonna hit my table. Blackjack is where most of these casino gameplay bits are gonna be, because I actually really like blackjack.
Show me what you got.
Ooh. I'm feeling. Oh boy. Oh boy.
What should I do? I hate
17 and 18. Because, like, at that point, all you can really do is just pray.
I'll take that.
That you either get your money back or that they go bust. And, like, I had to pull so many cards that didn't make me happy. I don't like that.
Not going to lose.
Smoke Christie's gonna make some money off of this. Can I get that? Thank you. Wow, okay. There's a good chance that we all get filthy rich. I'm gonna stay safe. I'm gonna stay right here.
This can't be right.
We're all gonna get our money back. We're all just going home. Let's take the money and run. Alright, 14. It's a little risky because this game is really fond of throwing out tens, but we've already seen multiple. I'm staying right there.
Not bad.
Thank you. Okay. And my goal, I'm going to hit the casino every night. My goal is going to be to leave them with more than I came in with. And knowing my luck and the fact that we're already up on, like, close on time on the video, I'm going to just back down real quick. And also, there's slot machines. And one thing I want to do with each character is, you know, every night they play, like, five or so pulls of their machine, except for Christie, because, oh my god. Like, I'm going to show you Christie's machine after these next four pulls. So, each machine is different, and I like that you can move the camera with the right stick. Can we get it? Nope. And each one is different, so Kasumi's is, like, the easiest. Like, there's no risk to it. And, like, it's pretty easy because it's any one of the bird or the shells you get three times back and five times back. You got nothing. And you get 200 times back if you manage to hit the full Kasumi jackpot, and, like, that's not going to happen. Because I swear the odds are stacked against you. Because there's two kinds of machines. We have just the positive machines, and then we have the machines like this one with Tina and Christy, where, as you can see down at the bottom, there are negative bets. So if you hit those, you lose, like, that multiplier of what you bet. And that's why the Christie one is where the hidden content in this game is hidden. Because look at that. Minus 500 times what you put in. Oh, man. Like, you know how I said I made 8 million on the roulette? Well, I went and hit this machine and I got the jackpot, like, 6 times. You need 9 times to unlock the secret content. And I got it 6 times, and I'm literally not kidding. 5 times in a row I got the minus 500. And, like, that just broke my spirit. But, one thing about the slots is, like, they have all different odds, but I'm pretty sure that the ones that have negatives pay out more just because, like, they're more likely to just give you something so that then they can punish you by having it be a negative. But they pay out more, tend to, in my experience, just because they come to a proper result rather than just sitting there spinning your wheels doing nothing. We got poker. And that's the casino. We'll do poker tomorrow. Like, I already spent time hesitating at the blackjack table. But anyways, this is Dead or Alive Extreme 2. Like, that's pretty much all of it. I'll show more of the mini games. I unlocked two of them. I'll show those in the next video. And then we're going to unlock the other ones, and I'm going to show those. And, like, you'll see them all. But, like, that's really it. It's just you pick what you do, and you do it, and you have fun. And that's why I'm probably going to enjoy this Let's Play, because it's free form. I can just do what I want. It's great. As long as I meet the goals, I'll be happy. Anyways, that's enough rambling for me. We're well acquainted with the game now, and I guess tomorrow the free form fun begins. So this has been Jetly One, and I will see you after Kasumi wakes up in the morning. See you then. Is this love that I'm feeling?